We are into episode 30 of our journey into life. In this episode, we will see Baghavad Gita. So most of us must have read Baghavad Gita many times and we are aware of it. Still, we are going to see some bits about it, because we have gone through the basics of what affects our daily life and some important religious concepts about God, and then some scriptures, important scriptures on Advaita Vedanta. So Bhagavad Gita is the essence of all Upanishads, and so it is also an important document, and there is no harm in going through that again, even if you know, and we will be seeing this briefly. So some selections I'll explain here. One whose soul is unmoved by circumstance, one who accepts pleasure and pain with equanimity, only he is fit for immortality. Meaning of Bhagavad Gita, he is called the Lord, Bhagavad, who knows the origin and end, the coming and going of beings, what is wisdom and what is ignorance. This is a quote from Vishnu Purana, chapter 6, 5, 7, 8. The word Bhagavad means God or the Supreme Lord. Bhagavan in Sanskrit, Gita means song. Thus, the Bhagavad Gita means the song of the God or the sacred song or song celestial. Bhagavad Gita is also known as Gita Upanishad. Srimad Bhagavad Gita is a dialogue between Lord Krishna and Arjuna narrated in the Bhishma Parva of Mahabharata. Gita was put together by sage Vyasa, who also edited the four Vedas. It has 701 verses in 18 chapters and has the essence of all Vedas and Upanishads. The background of Bhagavad Gita. In ancient times, there was a king who had two sons, Dhritarashtra and Pandu. Dhritarashtra was born blind. Therefore, Pandu inherited the kingdom. Pandu had 5 sons called Pandavas, and the Dhritarashtra had 100 sons called Kauravas. Duryodhana was the eldest of the Kauravas. After the death of the king Pandu, his eldest son Yudhishthira became the lawful king. Duryodhana was very jealous. Duryodhana wanted the entire kingdom for himself. He tried several evil plots to kill the Pandavas and take away their kingdom. All peace talks by Lord Krishna and others failed, so the war of Mahabharata could not be avoided. The entire 18 chapters of the Gita are talk between the confused Arjuna and his best friend, mentor and cousin Lord Krishna on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Kurukshetra is located in north of present Delhi, India. Main theme: the central teaching of Gita is attainment of eternal freedom. This is achieved by doing one's prescribed duties of life or the path of devotion or the path of knowledge. Gita presents three main aspects of the self. One, this is very important. Gita presents three main aspects of self: the immortality of the self, the need for self-realization, and the method of self-realization. The immortality of self, the need for self-realization, and the method of self-realization. The analogy of Gita is, the world is one huge battlefield. The real Kurukshetra is within us. The battle of the Mahabharata is still raging within. Ignorance is Dhritarashtra. The individual being is Arjuna. The indweller of our heart, our self or spirit, is Lord Krishna. The charioteer, the body is the chariot. The senses are 5 horses: mind, egoism, mental impressions, senses, cravings, likes and dislikes, lust, jealousy, greed, pride and hypocrisy are your dire enemies. So this is the analogy which is important, which pertains to our life. So the battlefield is nothing but this world, and we are Arjuna and Krishna is the soul. Gita selections, we will see some selections of Gita. Sloka 2:17. Know that which is self, that is self. to be imperishable, by which all this is pervaded. None can cause the destruction of that, the inexhaustible. Sloka 224. This self cannot be cut, burnt, wetted, nor dried up. It is eternal, all-pervading, stable, everlasting, and immovable. Sloka 253. When your mind, perplexed by what you have heard, stands steady and firm in the self, then you will attain yoga, that is realization. That is, when the mind is steady and firm in the self, then you will attain realization. Sloka 255. When a man, satisfied in the self alone by himself, completely casts off all the desires of the mind, then he is said to be one of steady knowledge. When the man completely casts off all the desires of the mind, then he is said to be one of steady knowledge. Sloka 271. That man attains peace, which is a realization, who, abandoning all desires, moves about without attachment, without selfishness, without vanity. Sloka 3-4. Not by abstaining from actions does man reach actionlessness, nor by mere renunciation does he attain perfection. Sloka 3-17. That man verily who rejoices only in the self, who is content in the self alone, for him there is nothing to do. The man who is content with the self, that he has nothing to do. Sloka 327. All actions are done in all cases by the energies of nature only. He whose mind is deluded by the egoism thinks, I am the doer. Sloka 328. But who he knows the truth, O mighty armed, about the divisions of energies and their functions, is not attached, thinking that energies act upon the energies. Sloka 339. O Arjuna, wisdom is enveloped by this constant enemy of the wise, in the form of desire, which is unappeasable as fire. Sloka 418. He who can see inaction in action, and action in inaction, he is wise among men. He is a yogi, performer of all actions. A man who sees action in inaction, inaction in action, and action in inaction, he is wise among men. He is a yogi and performer of all actions. Sloka 422. Satisfied with what comes to him by chance, rising above the pairs of opposites. Satisfied with what comes to him by chance, rising above the pairs of opposites, free from envy, even-minded in success and failure, though acting, he is not bound. Sloka 589. I do nothing at all. Thus will the knower of truth think, seeing, hearing, touching, smelling, eating, going, sleeping, breathing, speaking, letting go, ceasing, opening and closing eyes, convinced that the senses move among the sense objects. Sloka 513. Renouncing all actions by thought and self-control, the embodied one rests happily in the nine-gated city, neither at all acting nor causing act. Sloka 515. The Lord takes neither the evil nor even the good deed of any. Wisdom is enveloped by ignorance, thereby mortals are deluded. Sloka 6-2. O Arjuna, know yoga to be that which they call renunciation. No one becomes a yogi who has not renounced thoughts. Sloka 6-5. Let a man raise himself by himself. Let him not lower himself, nor, for he alone is the friend of himself, he alone is the enemy of himself. Sloka 6-29. With the mind made steady by yoga, he sees the self abiding in all beings and all beings in the self. He sees the same everywhere. Sloka 7-10. Know me, O Arjuna, as the eternal seed of all beings. I am intelligence of the intelligent, the bravery of the brave. Sloka 10-20. I am the self, O Gudakesa, seated in the hearts of all beings. I am the beginning, I am the middle, and I am also the end of all beings. Sloka 12-13 and 14. He who hates no creature, who is friendly and compassionate to all, who is free from attachment and egoism, balanced in pleasure and pain, and forgiving, ever content, steady in meditation, possessed of firm conviction, self-controlled, with mind and intellect dedicated to me, he, my devotee, is dear to me. Sloka 13:15. Without and within all beings, the unmoving and also the moving, because of his subtlety, unknowable, and near and far away is that. Sloka 17:16. Serenity of mind, good-heartedness, silence, purity of nature, self-control, this is called mental austerity. Serenity of mind, good-heartedness, silence, purity of nature, self-control, and this is called mental austerity. So this is some selections which we have seen from Bhagavad Gita. The references I'll give in the end. And the important thing is we have gone through most of the things which are key to us. Though briefly, it is enough. Even one word is enough for realization. The Mahavakyas are good enough for realization. You need not interpret and go on doing it. And so next we will be seeing liberation. We have seen enough, so we will be seeing liberation. After that chapter, we will go into another series. Please subscribe to my channel. Press the bell icon and like button. Thank you.